हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। वी आर ऑन पेज नंबर 73। लेट्स स्टार्ट। माइंड यू स्टूडेंट्स, दिस ट्राई दिस पार्ट इज ओमिटेड, बट आई विल जस्ट टेल यू इन ब्रीफ व्हाट इज देयर इन दिस ट्राई दिस पार्ट। योर लिस्ट ऑफ सर्टन गुड्स दैट यू यूज डेली इज गिवन। यू हैव टू नेम द कंपनी or the product or the brand that you are using, and how did you came to know about that product, or what was the source of information. For example, if you are using toothpaste, say Pepsodent, okay, so you can write down the source of information was television advertisement or magazine advertisement or newspaper advertisement, or you have your friend recommended you, so this will be your source of information. In this way you have to complete this box, but this is not there, but I gave you the information because the next paragraph is related to the same. After answering the questions above, you must have realized that it is necessary to have quality goods. Now mind you students, I have given you the information that suppose you are using the paste Pepsodent. Why are you using that particular brand, or why are you using that particular paste? The reason is it is of good quality. It is not giving you any trouble. Okay? So if the product is of good quality, you will be buying the same. Also, its advertisement also affects us. Seeing the advertisement, maybe on television or in the newspaper, you are tempted to buy or try that thing for the first time. So the quality of the product as well as the advertisement affects us to buy the product. Am I right? Everyone doesn't possess the knowledge about every product, but when we see others using the product, or if we see the advertisement for the product, when we inquire about it or see it in the market, it occurs to us that we need to use this product and we buy it. Now this is the answer of the question, what prompts you to buy that particular product? Here's the answer. Everyone doesn't possess the knowledge of every product that is available in the market. Am I right? You don't know about so many different brands or so many different types of paste available in the market. Okay, then how do we come to know about it? But when you see the others using that product, if you see somebody else is using that product, for example, if you have gone to a relative to stay there overnight, and when you use the paste that they were having and you like that particular taste of it, or maybe the quality of it, you decide to try the same. Okay, so when you see others using the product, let me give you one more example. Suppose your friend have brought a new mobile phone, he gives you to see the same. You see the different nice features in that mobile phone. So when you see your friend has brought that mobile, and when you see nice features in it, you are tempted to buy the same. Clear? So the first one, what have tempted you to buy that product? Answer number one will be when you see others using the product. Let us move ahead. Or if we see the advertisement about the product, the advertisement on television, radios or any other mass media is many a times very tempting. You see your favorite actor or a player advertising that product. Okay, such an advertisement prompts you to buy the product. You will definitely want to try the product on seeing that advertisement. That reminds me students, when I've been to a shop, I heard a small boy telling his mother, "Mama, will buy the biscuit where it is said that aaj to Tommy ka upvas hai." So can you see how much influence that advertisement had on that small boy? He did not know the name of that product, but he knew the advertisement that was shown. So advertisement definitely affects the customer buying the product. So we have seen the first one was when we see others using the product. Next we saw when we see the advertisement of the product, and the third one, when we inquire about it. When we inquire about it, suppose you are inquiring, suppose you go to the shop or the market and you ask, "Tell me how many brands of paste are there, show me all the types of paste." And when you see the different types of paste in front of you, and when you compare maybe the ingredients used, the price, the packing and so on, you will be making a choice. So when you inquire about different products, or when you see in the market, when they are nicely displayed in the market, it has prompted you to buy that product. Am I clear? So it occurs to you that you need that product and you buy that product. So why have you brought that product? What has prompted you to buy that product? Firstly, when you see others using it, when you see the advertisement, when you inquire about it, or when you see it nicely displayed in the showcases in the market, you will be tempted to buy the product. Shall I move ahead now? All this is possible because of marketing. Good marketing promotes business. Very important sentences. All this is part of marketing. A good advertisement, a good display, okay? These are all part of marketing. So when you are marketing the product very nicely, your business will expand. We come to the next part, importance of marketing. Modern industrial social fabric, globalization, and availability of abundant choices or alternatives of the product is the structure of today's business world. Another important sentence. What is the structure of today's business world? Modern industrial social fabric, globalization, and availability of abundant choices or alternatives of the product is the structure of today's business world. Let us see them in detail. Modern industrial social fabric. Now, today's age is about modern products, where everybody in the society is using those things. So modern industrial, that is latest goods in your society. Globalization, you know what is globalization? We have seen in the previous chapter of economics. And availability of abundant choices. Okay, if I go to buy a soap, so many different types of soaps are available. So I can buy from different, at least 20 different types of soaps available. So I have a lot of choice. So modern industrial social fabric, globalization, and availability of abundant choices or alternatives of the product is the structure of today's business world. In this context, the existence of marketing system for trade is very important. So when at least 20 different types of a product were available, how do you think your product will be sold in the market? Here, marketing plays very important role. Through marketing, one can increase business systematically. Another important sentence, through marketing, one can increase business systematically. The production can be distributed all at once on a large scale. If your marketing is so strong, so systematic and so powerful, it might so happen that all your products are sold at one go and on a large scale. So all the production can be distributed all at once. All the products manufactured might be over. Maybe if you have advertised your product so well, let us take an example of a mobile. Before it is launched, if there is a very strong advertisement, very strong marketing of the same, before the product enters the market, there is demand for the same, order has been placed, maybe advance has been placed, and the day it is launched, it is sold out. Is it clear? So it has been sold out all at once. So what is required here? Production of the same on a large scale. Here you should not make only few mobiles, but it should be produced on a large scale so that that large demand can be fulfilled. The product can reach a large number of consumers. Through advertisement, through proper systematic marketing, your product can reach large number of consumers or even the global consumers. The selling price of the product also increases. Suppose your marketing is very systematic, very strong, of course your selling price is going to be increased. Mind you students, the soft drinks that you get in the market, okay, say suppose that bottle cost you rupees 12, I'm just giving an example, but its production cost is not more than 2.50, that is 2 rupees 50 paise. But how much are you getting it for in the market? For rupees 12. The reason is, it has been marketed in such a way, the advertisement has been in such a way the brand ambassador, the money that is being given to him is in such a way, is so large that of course it is going to increase the price of the product, and the consumer will have to bear the same. So the product which was costing, production cost which was only 2 rupees 50 paise, has been increased many folds. Okay, so selling price of the product also increases. So ultimately the cost of the product that the consumer has to pay also increases. Also, defective product can be recalled from the market. If there is any defective product, and if you want to keep the name of your company held up high, all the defective products immediately should be replaced without any grumbling, without any problem. The customer should not lose faith on you. So immediately all the defective products should be taken back. Either money for the same or a new product should be given in exchange. Therefore, in today's era, marketing is vital part of trading system. So marketing is very, very, very important in today's trading system. Or you can say marketing is very important in modern industrial social fabric. Excuse me. Advertisement making the consumer feel the need to buy the goods are on rise. So advertisement should be such that your customers should feel the need to buy the product. On seeing the advertisement, one must feel that I need this product. Okay, see, and a lady maybe of the age of 40-45, if she sees an advertisement where it is said that this particular hair color will give the color to your hair which will last for, say, suppose 2 weeks or more than that, she will be tempted to buy. Okay, because in this age the coloring, the graying of the hair starts and one requires to apply hair color. So the advertisement should be such that that particular age group people are targeted in such a way that they will immediately on seeing the advertisement feel the need to buy the product, and next time they go to the market they will be demanding the product. Let me give you one more example. Your marketing should be so strong, okay, particularly during the time of exams. Some health drinks are being shown and marketed in such a way, okay, saying that it increases your memory. Okay, so parents will be tempted to buy such health drink which increases the memory of the children, to be given, to be fed to the children, particularly before and during the exam. So can you see, your advertisement should be such and should be so strong, and it should appeal, the appealing value of it should be such that the customer immediately feels the need to buy the product. Reaching maximum customers, attracting customers to the product, and making consumers buy the product are the objectives behind advertisement. Behind them means behind advertisement. Another objective, another one sentence answer. What are the objectives of advertisement? Why is a particular product advertised? The reason is so that it can reach maximum customers, it can attract the customer to the product, and it can make the consumer buy the product. Okay, advertisement should be such that it should be shown everywhere, maybe in the newspaper, radios, magazines and television, and it has reached the customers. Okay, then it should attract, your advertisement should be such that it should be remembered by your customer, so that the next time they go to the market they will buy the product. So what are the objectives behind advertisement? Reaching maximum customers, attracting the customers, and making the customers buy the product. Let us move ahead. In recent times, information technology and media has affected the marketing system deeply. Information technology and media. Now students, I don't have to tell you that nowadays online buying and selling is going on. Amazon, Flipkart, and so many different medias are there for you to buy. You don't need to go out to buy the product. So can you see here, information technology and media is affecting the marketing system. Not only that, there are certain apps, certain places where you can even sell your old products. Because of the revolution in the field of information technology, the whole world has become a big market. So because of information technology, the world has shrinked, the world has come closer, and your product can go through anywhere to any place in the world. So the whole world is your market. Through internet, we can get information about the production taking place in various continents. Through internet, we can come to know which product is being manufactured in which country. So anything, any information, internet is there to answer the same. This makes numerous options available to the customers. So the customer can buy the thing from internet, via internet, from any countries these days. It is due to the internet that customer can use facilities like online trading, e-marketing, etc. Okay, we come to always remember part. Now look here, student. An invisible flow develops when the product goes from producer to consumer. So that flow is shown here below. The commodity, okay, the price of the same, the promotion of the same, and it is distributed finally. So you can see that flow being shown there. An invisible flow develops when a product goes from the producer to the consumer. The commercial function involved in this flow are collectively called marketing. So here is the answer of your question, what is marketing? So what is marketing? The commercial function involved in the flow are collectively called as marketing. Okay. The price of the commodity, sales promotion, advertising and distribution are the major components of marketing. Let us see that flow very properly. A commodity, okay, what is required for it to be sold? Production of the commodity, classification, branding, labeling, packaging, okay, and then the price is decided, promotion is done, and then it is distributed. An example of the same is given below. What is that commodity here? Here you are taking the commodity as rice. Okay, let the type of the rice be basmati. So can you see basmati is shown under the heading of production, classification. Now even that rice are of different categories. What are the different category? Whole basmati, broken basmati, dubar, etc. If I am not mistaken, dubar means broken into two pieces. Okay, so these are the different classification of it. Then branding. Under branding, what will come? Name of the company, logo and number. Then we come to labeling. In the labeling, you will see the details about the quality of production, price, advertisement and distribution. So always you look for that on that label, on that packaging, you will see, you will try to find out what is the maximum price, what is the packaging date and all that. So that will come under the heading of labeling. Then we come to packaging. A very nice attractive package is there. So packing, looking at the packing should attract the customers. Fine. Students, we are now on the last page of the lesson. Page number 74. If a product is advertised using incorrect information, fraudulent means, or making exaggerated statements to cheat the consumer, pointing out the shortcomings of the competitors, that advertisement tends to lose our trust many a times. Nowadays, students, advertisements are made in such a way that it might give you wrong information or incorrect information. You have used fraudulent means which are not correct, which are illegal. Okay? And suppose you have made many exaggerated statement. I am just giving an example, I am not trying to criticize any product, but suppose a fairness cream says that using this cream, okay, your skin color is going to be very fair. Now do you think using a fairness cream, a dark colored person will become fair overnight? Definitely not. Even if the person is using the cream for many years, there might hardly be any change. So sometimes advertisements are made exaggerating the statement. Now this is to cheat the consumer and to sell the product. Okay, so sometimes wrong information is given, sometimes wrong means are used to advertise, sometimes statement is exaggerated, or sometimes pointing out the shortcomings of the competitors, saying that my product is better than that particular product is also wrong. Then what will happen? You are losing the trust of the consumer. Therefore, while advertising, it is necessary to follow the rules and regulation. There are certain rules and regulations. Okay, the product which is there in the company, which is there in the market for a long time, and if a new product is launched, both of them become competitor products. So if the new product says that old product, this is wrong, I am better, then you are going against the rules and regulation. The consumer should be aware of such advertisement. That is why Consumer Protection Act has been enacted. And if you are cheated by such advertisement and you are prompted to buy a wrong product, you can definitely complain in the Consumer Protection Act. Okay, under the Consumer Protection Act, you can definitely complain to the consumer courts. It is necessary that the consumer recognizes his needs and buy goods at reasonable rate. So a consumer should logically think whether he really needs the thing and whether he is buying the thing at the right rate. Just by looking at a very nice, very tempting advertisement, one should not buy if one does not require that product. So consumer should always be thinking logically with his or her brain and buy the thing only when he or she needs it, and that too at a reasonable rate. Is the chapter clear, students? Thank you very much.